and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be showing you guys the makeup look that I had in my last video. I got a lot of comments asking to do the makeup look. Also, I decided to show you guys multiple hairstyles. Some of you guys liked the space buns, some of you guys hated the space buns. So I'm giving you three hairstyles with one look. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it and subscribe to my channel so you can be notified every time I make another video. Yeah, so I hope you guys like this look. I hope you guys like this video and I will see you in my next one. Hey y'all, so I'm starting off with my Clean and Clear Dual Action Moisturizer and I'm just prepping my face. Then I'm taking my Benefit Gimme Brow Brow Gel and I'm just putting that all over my brows. I'm then taking my e.l.f. Brow Pencil in the color Taupe and I'm going to be outlining my brows. I'm taking an angled brush and I'm using my Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade in the color Chocolate and I'm just filling in the rest of my brows. I'm using my e.l.f. Concealer in the color Light and I'm just cleaning up my brows and also highlighting around them. I'm taking my e.l.f. Poreless Face Primer and just putting that all over my face. I'm taking the same e.l.f. concealer that I used before and I'm just highlighting slash concealing my face. So I'm putting it under my eyes, my bridge of my nose, my forehead, and my chin. I'm then taking a beauty blender and I'm just gonna blend that out on my face. I'm going in with my MAC Studio Fix Powder Foundation in the color NC42 and I'm just gonna cover my face with that. I'm just taking my e.l.f. HD powder and I'm going to set my under eyes. I'm going in with my Maybelline Fit Me powder foundation in the color 360 and I'm just going to contour with that. Then I'm taking my Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion and just putting that on my eyelids. And then I'm going to set that with the same HD powder by e.l.f. So I actually left my palette at school, so I'm going to be taking this light brown powder shade in an e.l.f. eyebrow kit and that is going to be my transition shade. Then I'm going back in with the same Maybelline Fit Me powder foundation in the color 360 and that is going to be my main crease color. It is just like a chestnut brown color, so just find something that looks similar to that. Actually went a little too hard, so I'm going in with a makeup wipe just to clean it up.
I'm then going in with my ColourPop Glow Up Highlighter, and that is going to be my main lid color, so I'm just packing that on my lid. And I'm just lining my waterline with a black pencil eyeliner. And I'm going to be putting on my Ardell Glamour Lashes in number 106. And I put them on off camera because I was going to mess up if I didn't. And then I'm taking this small angle brush and I'm taking the same crease color and I'm putting it under my eye to smoke it out a little bit. And I'm taking the same color that I put on my lid and I'm just going to put it in my tear duct. And I'm taking that same color and highlighting my cheekbones and the bridge of my nose. And then I'm going in with my ColourPop Super Shock Shadow in the color Blaze. And this just adds like all the sparkle to my highlight. Like y'all gotta get it. And I'm going back over with the brow gel just to make sure that they stay. And for the lip color that everybody is asking about, I first put on Limbo by ColourPop. Once that color dries, I go on top of it with Abu Dhabi by NYX. And that is more of a creamy consistency, so I'm just trying to pat it dry so I can put Stone by MAC on top of it. I just pat it all over to make it like a grayish look. I don't know. All right, you guys, so that's the final makeup look, and now moving on to my hair. So for these next couple of hairstyles, I usually do them on my last couple of days of my hair being straight because it starts getting greasy and weird. So the first style I am showing you guys are the space buns. So I just do a middle part and then I tease my hair a little bit. And from there, I just take a hair tie and I kind of just scrunch it up into a ball, real messy. I don't care what it looks like. And just make the little buns. After you make the buns, I just take out a few spare hairs just to make it look a little bit more messy, and I use bobby pins to pin the buns to make them more secure. And to lay my edges, I go in with the Curls Blueberry Bliss in a toothbrush, and I just kind of sleek them down a little bit. Okay, so say space buns are not for you. You do not like space buns. So the next style is just going to be a wavy down style. So I'm just wanding my hair. I'm not caring which strands I take or how big or small they are. I'm just making super messy waves and curls. After I finish that, I just flip it over and fluff it up a little bit. And after that, you can kind of style it however you like, whether you like a middle part, a side part, whatever you like. And say you're not feeling that, I usually do this. This is my go-to look when my roots are greasy. I love the look of bandanas. I don't know, I just always put them on. So basically, I'm just putting on a black bandana, just wrapping it around my head and fluffing out my hair to make it look a little bit more voluptuous. And that is my final hairstyle, y'all. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you in my next one.
Masterpiece made with a mountain of steak, free of artificial preservatives and flavors, and a heavenly blanket of cheese. Now, just...